guys, I'm HappyMonsta. In this mod showcase video, I'm gonna show you some special and useful rails that you could use in your Minecraft world. So without further ado, let's get right into it. There are 8 items added in this mod, and let's start with a very simple one, which is the buffer stop. Basically, it just stops the minecart, so you could use this rather than using slabs. The buffer stop crafting recipe is 1 block at the middle, 3 iron ingots at the top, and 2 at the bottom corners. The next item is the high speed rail. So it said it can travel 5 blocks per tick. That means it can travel 100 blocks per second. If I compare this with a normal powered rail, as you see, the high speed rail is so much faster than the powered rail, and you will need redstone torch to power it. The next one is a speed clamp rail. It's slower than the high speed rail, but also a bit faster than the powered rail. It travels 0.5 blocks per tick. The crafting recipe is 4 iron ingots at the corners, 2 slime balls at the side, a diamond, a stake, and a redstone dust at the middle row. The direction rail is basically allows the minecart to travel in one direction. So if you want the minecart to go back, you can't really do that. And this rail also needs redstone torch to be powered. To craft this, you will need 6 iron ingots at the sides, redstone dust at the middle, redstone repeater, and a stake. Moving on to intersection rail. So normally, rails cannot cross over and the minecart just turn to the left or the right. But if you put the intersection rail at the middle, both carts can intersect or cross over each other, which is very useful. The crafting recipe is very simple, just surround the stake with iron ingots. The next rail is my favorite one, which is the teleport rail. This rail can teleport you and your minecart anywhere you want, even to different dimensions, kinda similar to the enderpearl. So you will need 1 stake at the middle, diamond at the top, redstone dust at the bottom, 4 iron ingots at the corners, and 2 ender pearls at the sides. So let's say this is my starting point, and I want to teleport to here. What you need to do is place a normal rail or any kind of rail where you want to get teleported to. Then throw the teleport rail and the ender pearl on top of the rail. When the lightning strike appeared, that means it has set the location. Then go back to the starting point, place the teleport rail here, and now you will need to activate it by right-clicking on it, and you will need to put enderpearls in it. So the enderpearls act as a field in this situation. Here, it will show you some information about the dimension, coordinates where the rail will teleport you to, and how much field you need. And last, don't forget to use a redstone torch to power it up, and now you can use the teleport rail. You can also have as many teleport rails as you want to teleport to different places. And if you want to deactivate the rail, just put it into the crafting table and it will reset it. Now we have the single track builder and the double track builder. Basically, this gadget helps you to build rail roads, rather than building it manually. So for the single track builder, right click on it and there's a menu for you. At the top right corner, we have 4 different modes. No extra tunnel means it will just build you a rail road. A 3x3 air tunnel builds you a 3x3 tunnel with no lights. 5x5 air tunnel does the same thing, and tunnel with blocks and lights. Basically, it builds you tunnels with blocks and lights. After you chose a mode, you will need to put rails in it. The only rails you could use are powered rail, high speed rail, and speed clamp rail. Next is the ground blocks, and the only blocks you could use here is gravel. So gravel is the only block you could use for your ground. Tunnel blocks are blocks for your tunnel. The only blocks you could use are stone, cobblestone, stone bricks, sandstones, granite, dunnerites, and andesites. Here you will put redstone torches for your rails, torches over here, and coal as a fuel. After you put all your stuff in this device, just shift right click and it will build a railroad for you. The double track builder is the same thing as the single track builder, but it builds you 2 tracks. So yeah, that's all the information about this mod, Useful Railroads. I hope you guys enjoy it. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have an awesome day. Bye!